Right, so we've got to be, this is called snake oil because we've got to be that kind of salesman.
Yes, exactly. So you're trying to sell complete garbage to people. one second, let me just draw the two more. There we go.
So do we tell you the card what it is until after you've bought it or something? Like, do we have to sell a pitch? And
no,
then...
no. What you do is sell voice, you try and start selling a pitch, but you've got to combine two items together, and that has got to be your item.
Right.
You can you show your item, you know, like I did with the...
Yep, I understand.
Ball. Yeah. Right, so... So I just need two of those. There we go. So...
Should I pick up two?
Yeah, if you've only got four cards, pick up two. Yeah. Did you just... You just flipped the whole thing!
I just pressed two.
Right, press... You got them?
I got six.
Got six, cool.
Somehow right. it flipped the cards too.
So, this time, I've come into your guys' weird shop for some weird reason, and I am a billionaire. So what would a billionaire want, in other words?
I know what a billionaire would want.
Alright, you can go first if you want to, mate.
A billionaire would want something. Right. So, first of all, sir, you're going to have lots of money, yeah?
Yeah.
To keep that money safe, you don't need a bank account, you don't need a wallet, you need the money bottle.
Right.
Stick that money in the bottle and no greedy people, greedy Jews, can stick the fingers in the bottle and take out your money. That's what you need, to a money bottle. Impregnable. Impregnable by water, because you can put the cork in, keep your money safe. Everyone looks in through the green glass. And all of that money will look like it's water because of the special green glass that is used. It makes it just look like an ordinary bottle of water.
Well, I've got a question. I've got a feeling this bottle's going to be quite huge. Where am I supposed to be putting this bottle?
No. The bottle actually shrinks the money down to the size of like a droplet of water. That's why everything looks like water when it's in it.
Okay. Right. I'll be back with you in a minute then. What about you, Mr. Wiz?
Well, as you're a millionaire, there's not a lot you can't have.
Yep.
But there's one thing. I know you have loads of money, but do you have a... But where are you going to put all that money? I'll tell you where. And if you're hungry, you can have some chocolate wallet.
Oh!
Now you could be rich and satisfied with a delicious chocolate.
Ooh. Well, quick question though. Wouldn't the... while it melts in my
but
pocket.
But you're rich, so who gives a fuck?
But
you have
off.
A point there, I am quite rich, yes.
So now you can throw chocolate-covered money at poor people.
So, one second. So I've got either the money bottle... Oh, sorry. Wrong way. Flip that way. Oh. So have you ever got the money bottle, or the chocolate wallet? well... I've got a feeling though, with the chocolate wallet, I will have to buy quite a lot of those. And what about my poor money that's inside it? I'm gonna guess it's gonna get ruined. Now come on, I've only got a...
It wouldn't get ruined in the money bottle.
It wouldn't get ruined in the money bottle. But at the same time... with this bottle, like you said, it shrinks down my money. How am I supposed to get the money back out of it? I've got to smash the bottle, haven't I? And then what happens? Would all my money just spread out?
No.
You
don't have to smash it. You can open the cork, and only when you tip it out, it becomes money again.
Okay.
Someone else tips it out, it stays as water.
Did I tell you it was chocolate?
What kind of chocolate?
Chocolate gives you diabetes.
It gives you diabetes.
Well, one minute. What kind of chocolate is this wallet?
It's like the chocolate you get in the pound coin chocolate.
Fuck that, I'm going with the money bottle.
Cheap chocolate lost you the game.
I'm going to put that there for you. So, so flip that. There we go. Put these all together, and then we shuffle them back in. So you guys, you might want to pick two more cards once this has been shuffled. You want to shuffle? Yeah, there you go.
What about the billionaire there?
Oh no, the billionaire stays there. That's Shimmy's point.
Okay.
So we're saying it's first to five, yeah?
Yep.
Right, okay, Shimmy, your turn to pick a job. So you pick, send two into your pile from the job list.
Right. Oh, I get two, don't I?
Yeah, two.
Ooh.
So
okay, I'm going to go for Vampire.
Ooh, okay.
What would a vampire want?
Oh, I've got it already.
Oh, this is quite tough.
I'll give you a clue, this vampire's allergic to blood.
That's alright. Gonna put it in the middle. There you go.
No.
Put it over here. There you go. Boop.
What's the middle for you? Are you doing the pitch first?
I'm doing... No. If you want, you pick who pitch first.
He's doing the stream.
Yeah, I'm
You've
doing
got
the stream.
Alright, okay. Yeah. Well, Billy went second last time, we'll have Billy first.
Okay.
Alright. Well... being a vampire, you've got a few flaws like sunlight and time of day, and you've also got to worry about that smelly garlic. So I propose deodorant watch.
Deodorant watch.
Now you can smell good and not worry about sunlight.
Oh, it makes sense now, doesn't it?
All your fins, everything wrong with your mundane life. Now,
will it only stop my wrist from sweating?
No, you could just dab it, like, you just dab it on your pits and everything, and it's good. And you just go, oh, look, I've got like 2 hours to get home.
Late, sweating profusely. Right.
Vampirism intensifies.
Now, the problem is, with the deodorant watch, you have the limit of only being out during night time. Okay, it gives you time to tell you when you're supposed to go back home. But you want to be out all the time, don't you?
Yep.
So, I think you need some kind of shade that you can put over you.
Okay.
And that's why I have the perfect item for you, Mr. Vampire Shimmy. And yep. That item is the paint condom.
What the fuck?
Basically, it may look like a condom that's been painted, but it's basically a suit that you can put over yourself, and it will block the sunlight from hitting your very elegant body, sir.
Why does it have to be painted?
Yeah. Well, yeah, that's the great thing about it. It's a condom. It protects you from pretty much everything, and it holds everything. Well, he's a vampire. He doesn't need to breathe.
Yeah, I am dead, to be honest.
He's already dead, so it's not going to kill him. If anything, it's
but what
going
if his fans break through the condom?
That's the sunlight perfect gets thing. In. The great
it doesn't
thing
have to
about,
be airtight, I suppose.
Yeah, it doesn't have to be airtight. The great thing about a condom is very difficult to break.
It's be airtight. It's a condom, so it's
exactly.
Stripped.
So,
that's my the paint condom.
What do you do with the paint? What's the paint for?
That's basically the paint is what it's covered on the
but
outside.
But then how can he see?
That's a great point. there will be just a little window just for his eyes. Now, you may have to wear some sunglasses, but come on. That's just a little bit of a default, which we do sell. We sell them for about £50 at the moment. It's great. But like I said, the paint condom, great for you to run around and visit the world during the day.
With the deodorant watch, you don't look like a tit.
But with the paint condom, you can go out whenever you want.
I think purely for a vampire look after himself reason, I'll probably go... Probably go for the condom.
Yes!
I'd like Billy's idea, but actual real life.
You just had a condom, so that was an instant win.
Yeah, but I don't see how the deodorant would have saved me from the garlic.
Oop, grab your cards. I'm stealing your cards! Woo! Damn, I forget that I've got to hold it to make them all up.
I know when the hotline bling.
Shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. You, where's that come from?
Do?
I was there.
You just all the time.
Did I forget it?
Right, Billy's okay, turn.
Billy, really, let me shuffle them first, mate.
No, I just got them back. You can have my watch back.
Thanks.
And
the billionaire, baby.
Still, right, Mac.
Shuffle. Go and pick the
shuffle. I've got to pick two jobs as well, aren't I?
Yeah.
The Steve Jobs.
Yeah, damn, how did you find them at?
I know when the hotline bling.
Vampire.
Okay. You want a job?
Yep.
Yep.
What does a teenager want?
Okay. I know what the teenager wants.
Oh, perfect. Yes.
I know.
Don't forget to put the other card back into the jobs, mate, and then shuffle it.
Need you want that pink condom? What's the pit actually?
I'll do it, mate. Seeing him a little bit struggle there.
Help!
Help me with it.
Switch heads.
You stop robbing my teenager.
Right. Who do you want to go first, Billy?
Where? Oh, Shimmy.
Sorry.
Okay, well, every teenager has one problem. You want to continuously look at the phone, but when you get into bed, you always run out of charge. So I propose charging bed.
Damn.
Right? That's a good charger. You plug your charger, plug your bed into the mains, and with the new special touchscreen pads that they have now, the whole bed now can charge.
It's now a touchscreen.
Now it can now charge electrical any electrical device. That's phones, Nintendo DSs. I mean, you can even charge your laptop up so you can keep them memes, meme videos coming up on YouTube. Ainsley Harriet, hot, spicy meat. Without ever having to reach for that pesky plug down on the floor again.
Yeah, boy.
And don't forget, even though despite the ridiculous shape of that charger being all American with only two prongs and no health and safety earth, we will, if you did go abroad, we do have European adapters as well, so you don't have to worry about that.
That's
but
good.
Yeah, the charging bed, every teenager's dream, isn't it?
So, the bed charge is awesome, I guess, if you want to be like that. But you don't want to just be in bed, and be honest, you want to nap wherever you feel like, isn't it? Out in the sort of sun, and sometimes. And you might find a nice, cozy area just to lay your head down, yeah? Yep. So that is why I have introduced you to the pillow cap. It is basically a pillow that you can have on your head, and it looks stylish as well. It comes in a range of colours, like green. Racing green, bright green, and red, and other colours, and we do custom colours, of course. But yeah, it is basically just a pillow that you can wear on your head that you can just take off and lie down on, say, a bench that you see, and you can just lie down and have a quick nap, because everything is boring, and yeah, pretty much.
So now I like how it captures Nuka-Cola.
Yeah, that's ignore that. that's one of the brand deals. We don't talk about it too much, but come on, everyone loves Nuka-Cola. Come on, it's the in thing nowadays.
Well, The bed charger obviously has the perk of it can charge my devices, which is what I'll be on 24/7 as a teenager. GD has the portability as a perk, but it doesn't charge anything.
Yeah, but also ours is sponsored by the guy who acts in Deadpool, Ryan Reynolds.
Yeah, but
don't forget, the kids don't want to sleep. Do you want a constant wide up to the Facebooks and everything? So
yeah,
that's or
if you have the pillow cap, you can clap. If you have the pillow cap, you can sleep during the day to party all the night.
Yeah, but through the night, they're missing viable tweets.
Yes.
And posts.
Yeah, but you're sleeping.
They need to be moaning about being tired, yeah, but actually sleeping. That's teenagers. I'm going to have to go for the bed charger.
Fuck. I tried.
It speaks to teenagers more.
There you go. Give him the... Go collect your card then, Shimmy.
Good daddy. Yeah. That's damn right. I am the teenage millionaire.
Oh, fuck. Right, it's my turn now, isn't it?
Yep.
Right. What's that? A what? Right, so guys.
Yep.
I am the president.
Damn.
Woo me.
The shitty United States. I mean, the United States.
No, I'm the president of my own country. We don't talk about it too much, but we are better than the certain US.
Very nice.
Because we do not have guns. We have missiles instead. we don't. Oh, hi, Master Bay. So, explain to me. What do I, the president of Craveland, need?
I think I know.
You do?
I know my first card. Just trying to forget.
I know what the peasant needs.
Alright. You ready, Billy?
Hang on.
Why Billy's figuring it out? Okay then, Shimmy, tell me. What do I, the president of Craveland, need?
Right, you've got one problem being the president of Craveland. Things can go wrong, whether it's exploding creepers.
Of course, yeah, they are a bit of a nuisance.
Or catch dropping dodgy grenades on other FPS games that we shall not mention.
Okay, on then.
So, safety first, you need a coat that can protect you.
Okay.
And
safety coat.
Around Western time, coats may be made of wood.
A wood coat?
Wooden coat. It's kind of, you know, the basic armour in any game, isn't it, really? You make things out of wood. And and it protects you from those explosions, shootings.
Creepers.
What kind of wood?
Creepers. it's gopher wood.
Oh. I've heard that's supposed to be quite good.
Gopher's interesting.
So how is this wood coat, so is it supposed to protect me from, I don't know, a Kaj lava attack, for example?
Kaj lava attack?
Yes, a Kaj lava attack.
Well, the lava, you obviously just float on the lava, wouldn't you?
Not really, because lava burns.
No, not with this coat. This coat.
I've seen the YouTube
special
videos.
This coat.
If
this
it was
coat
made
was
of
treated
coconuts, it would be good.
It's treated with a special oil that doesn't burn.
Okay. Dude, I'm surprised because most oil, or pretty much all oils, can burn. But yeah, okay. What about you, Mr. Wiz? Will you interest me, the president of Craveland?
Well, physical threats are, you know, for them rare instances, but what every presidency has to face every few so years is election times. Oh, and we don't want a Kaj to be president of the next president of Craveland, do we?
Well, don't tell anyone. It's a bit more like a dictatorship, if anything. but yeah, continue.
So you're going to need a banner.
Okay.
In bread.
Is that a banner bread or a bread banner?
It's a banner bread.
It's a banner bread. Okay.
It's basically your presidential campaign. Inside, a slice of a loaf of bread. Everyone has bread. Everybody loves bread. Every time they go have a sandwich, they're going to see your ad campaign in their sandwich and go, wow, I need to vote for him.
He's already president, so he doesn't need a campaign.
1 minute.
But it does every 4 years.
So, quick question.
You need
so
to
is the banner actually inside the bread?
Yes. Every slice. Every slice. No. It's printed on the banner. It's edible banners.
It's edible banners. It's a banner made out of bread there.
Yeah.
Oh.
Banner bread.
Banner bread.
Banner bread.
What kind of bread?
White.
Okay, yeah, fair. everyone does. If it was whole grain, then that wouldn't work. Too many bits.
It's half and half, so you get maximum amount of votes. Oh. That.
Which is weird, because technically we've only got 8 people voting in our group. Which I'm surprised I've kept the presidency. But, okay, a bread a banner made out of bread, I guess. And then we've got the wooden coat. Do you know what? This is difficult to pick. For the fact
think how sexy you look in your wooden coat. And I'll tell you what. If you choose it now, I'll give you a splinter-free guarantee for the next 6 months.
You're always going to talk about splinters. So I could still get splinters in after 6 months with this banner, with this
wood coat. You won't, but it's only guaranteed up to the 6 months. Because by then, you're a snappy chap, you probably want to buy another one in the various colours we have.
I'm going to be honest
here. We actually use the same paint from the condom, painted condoms.
Oh, right. I've heard that's quite powerful. About 9 out of 10 vampires agree that it's useful. That one vampire is dead, by the way.
Sandwiches. Cravers love sandwiches.
It's got a point.
That's all we talk about. You can't lose now. You're going to be president for life.
What kind of sandwich?
Huh?
What kind
Everything.
Of sandwich?
Anything you want. Here's the bread. Now you get to make a bacon, a cheese.
Fuck it, he's got me. He mentioned the word.
Cheese.
No, bacon.
Yes.
No, he's got a point. No, no offense, but the wood coat. I don't want a splinter. And as much as all you can say, I've got a feeling Kedge will find a way to burn it.
Damn! Take the damn wood coat. Get the fuck out.
There we go. He's put them straight in.
Had a doopy.
I love how he's just. You know, put it on top. There we go. That would do.
Oh, I believe it. Woo, got a point, finally.
Well done, President Billy.
Oh, why did I pick 2 cards? I didn't need cards, did I? No.
Oh, I'm the guy now, aren't I?
Yeah, you're the guy. Let me just put these cards back first, and then reshuffle.
Oh, I need 2 cards.
There we go.
Hang on, I've got banner wood. I don't want banner wood. We just have banner wood.
I've seriously got that card again. Okay, I've got a good one though.
Okay, go on then, Shimmy.
Okay, I'm going to be a detective.
A detective?
A detective.
A detective. Well, spinny spin, spin, spin. I can't spin it properly. There we go. Perfect item.
Alright. What would the detective want?
Who do you want to go first, mate?
Magnum PI will hit Billy first.
Well, detective, you need to detect many things, whether it be sounds, noises. Me, I don't know. But one thing you might need to detect is heat for a thermometer. But, you know, it's so inconvenient to carry this all the time, and you want to look cool while doing so. So you need a belt, a thermometer belt.
A thermometer? Mention, what was that again? A what, sorry?
A thermometer.
Okay.
Thermometer belt. Thermometer belt.
Due to copyright.
Please explain why I would need it again.
Go on then, Billy, explain, please.
I've had dud cards, I'm sorry.
You have dud cards. Do you want me to just move on to mine, yeah?
Yes, I will come back to this one as well. I'll Billy figures out what the hell it's got to do with it.
Right, as a detective, you may find yourself into trouble sometimes, and you're very much trapped with your arms in the air, but you might see some kind of, I don't know, a remote control car, something that can be easily controlled. I'm guessing guns are now starting to be electronically controlled nowadays, aren't they? So that's why I think you will need the shoe controller. It's basically a universal controller that is implanted in your shoe, so you can control anything that is around you, as long as it has ability to be controlled, of course. By just using your tapping of your toes without using your hands. So it looks like you're not doing anything, but everything is going crazy. They may think that there's ghosts in the building.
So it's like an Inspector Gadget type shoe.
Like an Inspector Gadget kind of shoe, but it controls, like, for example, it turns the TV on and off, or it makes Justin Bieber play out on the MP3 player. Now, nobody wants that.
Yeah, Justin Bieber, I'm swinging back to Billy now after you mentioned it.
No. It's like a torture device, if anything.
Okay.
Yes. It's a controller. It's a shoe controller.
Okay. Back to Billy then. Come on, Billy.
Oh, fuck this. I mean, you might as well just get the point to GDW. I'm just fucked.
Quick question. What came across your mind thinking, thermometer belt?
Well, I just thought, thermometer, that does something.
It does something. It'll only measure your own temperature.
You can inspect something with that.
What, your own temperature?
Yeah. You can detect temperatures, and therefore you might solve a crime involving temperatures. And you have a belt to keep your pants.
I think, to be fair, GD's covers a bit more of ground, so I'm going to go for the controllable shoe.
Yeah, the shoe controller. Yes. Pleasure doing business with you, sir. Yeah, put that in there. Really? Come on, Billy. You couldn't learn how to put the cards on there now.
It's fine.
No, it's not.
Oh, look. I'll see. Okay, do it then.
There. Don't pick the cards up yet. Don't. Let me shuffle them first. You can actually see when they're being shuffled.
Oh, sweet, son. I just got the best fucking card.
Yeah, you're the one with the job next, mate.
I know, but it's there.
Okay, go on.
Oh, yes. What does a stripper need? Just nonchalantly, what does a stripper need? What would the stripper want to buy? I love how JD just giggles like a 50 schoolboy.
Oh god, this is good.
Okay. Stripper gonna need. Damn.
Yeah, what will the stripper need?
I know what the stripper will need.
Oh, I don't even know what a stripper needs.
My sausage.
My bean.
What does a stripper need?
What does a stripper need? Right. Who's going first?
GD, you go first.
Right. I'm going to move this card. So, I'm guessing as a stripper, you need some equipment to try and entertain the patrons of your strip club, of course. And nowadays, things are getting a bit more risky, and it's starting to reach a point that, thanks to certain Kardashian, things are basically being stepped up and up and up a bit. So that is why I recommend to you the bottle chair. I'll leave the rest to your imagination.
No. No.
Is that for you to sit on the bottle? Hey.
Oh, what are you collecting in that bottle?
You're not collecting anything, it's corked.
Is that the bottle? Is that the money bottle where she can keep her money in as well? Stick the money in Nick, as she can sit on the bottle chair and just keep the change, son.
Just make it rain in that bottle.
Oh God! Just move on, please. God.
Right. Well, what's the there's one need? Thing that a stripper needs to do, and that is to remain completely hairless, shaving foam. But modern day scents aren't that pleasing. The one thing to do where you can shave all that body hair off and smell completely delectable is the brand new chocolate foam.
Oh, sweet.
You can spray that chocolate foam all from head to toe without any forms of repetitions of rashes.
But
shave it off and you smell like a lovely piece of Cadbury's fruit and nut ready for the patrons to splash the cash and lick your booty.
But
damn.
But the bottle chair.
Oh,
yeah. I don't know. The you're going to have to sell it to me. Imagination ain't going to cut it this time.
Think of it this way. Shit. Okay, the bottle chair is a great idea, in my opinion, because if you think about it...
You've essentially just made a fucking toilet.
No. You're not thinking how the bottles are actually supposed to be used.
Let me just say, if you did get a bottle, you could use the chocolate foam as lubricant.
See, Shimmy understands, so you will need the bottle chair.
You'd need the chocolate for you need my items.
But you could
have yours.
But you don't need chocolate foam for that. You can use any kind of foam.
But it wouldn't be as delectable as the chocolate foam.
I've heard rumours about the chocolate foam. It attracts bees.
No, that's not honey. If that's honey foam, we got rid of the honey foam. It's chocolate foam.
Go on then, Billy. Just pick.
It's got chocolate foam.
You go with the chocolate foam,
it's
yeah.
It's got chocolate foam.
It's got to be chocolate foam.
I mean, I'm not even a stripper and I want that shit.
You won.
You did.
Thanks, stripper Billy.
You got a stripper partner, huh?
I'm a teenage stripper billionaire.
You're a teenage stripper billionaire.
Kinda.
Kinda, sorta. Sort of. Maybe eventually.
One day.
Are you kinda, Matt?
Eventually, I might on my way all the way up to Matt. You never know.
No, you can't.
I think last time wasn't a slight match. Matt.
There's twisted as Matt. He's kind of locked that down. He owns the websites.
Are you ready?